I recently took my Kia EV6 on a 500-mile road trip along freeways, backcountry roads, and hills. In this video, I'll share with you the data analytics from that trip and show you how the car did with range estimation, mileage efficiency, terrain, charging, route planning apps, and cost. A few weeks ago, I took my new Kia EV6 on a 500-mile road trip through California's Gold Country. If you'd like to see gorgeous Gold Country and watch our road tripping travel video, click on the link in the top right corner of your screen. This trip took us along freeways, back roads, and steep winding mountain roads. In order to show you how the car did with range estimation, efficiency, terrain, charging, and costs, I'll focus on certain key legs of our trip that highlight different situations. Before I do that, let's start with the overall route planning, because that's an important component in EVs. The EV6 has a built-in navigation system, but it doesn't plan out charging stops for you. For example, if I tell it I want to go from San Francisco Bay Area to Los Angeles, it will give me the routing and tell me I need to charge, but it won't suggest the optimal charging stops. You would have to do that manually, which is not particularly easy. So when I planned my Gold Country trip, I had to use an EV route planner app. There are two major ones, PlugShare and a Better Route Planner, or ABRP for short. I decided to use ABRP for this trip and entered in my entire route. It tells me that I will need to stop to charge twice, once in Turlock and the other time in Placerville. Now this is a real-world road trip. We had three adults in the car, our dog, and all of our luggage, so we can call it fully loaded. The car is a Kia EV6 all-wheel drive extended range GT line with 20-inch wheels. If you have an Ioniq 5 all-wheel drive, you can expect similar results since they share the same drivetrain. The first leg illustrates how well it performed on the freeway. We started with a full charge and an estimation of 278 miles of range left. Our leg was from San Francisco Bay Area to our charge stop in Turlock, about 100 miles away. Our route was mostly flat except for one section through the Altamont Pass where we had a couple of climbs up to 750 feet and then up to 1,000 feet. Not much of a climb there. The temperature ranged between 64 degrees at our start and 77 degrees when we arrived at the charge station. The actual distance traveled was 103 miles, but the range estimate had dropped by 116 miles, about a 12% increase over actual. The efficiency showed as 3.4 miles per kilowatt hour. I had been driving in normal mode with zero regen and at about 65 miles per hour on the freeway. Per ABRP, I should have arrived with 59% battery, but I actually arrived with 63. And while ABRP estimated that it should have taken me 19 minutes to recharge, in actuality, it took me 33 minutes, which is quite a bit more. I hit a peak charge power of 132 kilowatts. Our next leg was quite unlike the first. This one took us from Turlock to Mariposa in the Sierra foothills. This was on two-lane roads traveling at about 55 miles an hour or less and had us climbing to an elevation of about 2,500 feet in the last 20 miles of the route. After leaving the charge stop, I had put the car into eco mode as I was concerned about having enough range to get to the next stop. And as you'll soon see, that was a smart move. The mountain road climb definitely took a toll on the efficiency. By the time we got to Mariposa, the mileage was a dismal 2.8 miles per kilowatt hour. The actual miles traveled was 68 miles, but the range estimate had dropped by 78 miles, about a 14.7% increase over actual. We arrived with 70% charge, which is exactly what ABRP had estimated. And that is pretty impressive. The next day, we headed out to see a few sites, which took us on a crazy route. The section I want to focus on is from a site called Fremont's Fort Marker to Coulterville. This section had us starting at about 2,300 feet, dropping down to about 900 feet, and then climbing back up to 2,400 feet and then finally arriving in Colterville at about 1,700 feet. This roller coaster ride was completed in a distance of only 13 miles. It took us along numerous switchbacks, and I found that level 2 on the regen paddle in eco mode worked just great and allowed me to keep my foot on one pedal. Well, despite the uphill section, the mileage was still an impressive 4.9 miles per kilowatt hour, which means that on the downhills, it must have recharged the battery a huge amount in order to make up for the efficiency loss going uphill. We continued putting the car through its paces on the uphills and downhills on day 2 of our trip to the point where we were draining the battery pretty quickly. At the end of day 2, we arrived in Sonora with 44% of the battery instead of the 48 that ABRP had predicted. An ominous sign of things to come. At the end of day 3 was our charging stop in Placerville. We had some more hilly sections to drive through, along with rain and colder temperatures. All those factors combined brought us to the charge station with only 10% battery, instead of the 17 that ABRP had predicted. A little too close for comfort on my first trip. In retrospect, I'm glad I had put the car into eco mode when we left our last charge station. Otherwise, we simply might not have made it. But being at 10% had a silver lining. It allowed me to do a 10 to 80 to 100% charge test at the 350 kilowatt Electrify America charger. And wow, what a charge session it was. It hit 240 kilowatts, the maximum charge power that the EV6 can take. If you'd like to find out the time it took from 10 to 80% charge and see the charge curve, be sure to click on the link in the top right corner of the screen. It's pretty impressive. The full charge to 100% took 45 minutes, significantly longer than the 26 minutes that ABRP had estimated to go from 17% to 95%. Now, have you ever wondered what kind of mileage you'd get if you drove on a long downhill stretch? Well, the last day of our trip presented us with just that opportunity. We were headed from Placerville to the Marshall Gold Discovery State Historic Park. This route took us on a downhill going from 2,000 feet all the way to about 800 feet over the course of just 8 miles. The mileage? A whopping 24.3 miles per kilowatt hour. It's a shame the whole trip couldn't be done at that mileage. Maybe someday EVs might be able to. So I learned a number of things from this road trip. First, let's talk about ABRP. It's a big disappointment that the Kia's navigation system can't recommend charge stops like Tesla can. That's a real shortcoming of this car. But ABRP saved the day and did a great job planning the charge stops. Without it, I think it would have been really painful for me to do it manually. The battery state of charge predictions were pretty close, but of course it couldn't factor in a fully loaded car, rain, temperature, etc., all the variables that affect the range. With its latest update, ABRP has introduced the ability to process live data through an OBD dongle. I will have to try that out and see how well that works. But speaking of range, let's see how Kia's range estimation did. I kept logs of the actual miles covered along with the drop-in range and did this analysis. The drop-in range miles was about 11 to 14% more than the actual miles traveled, with a trip average of 12.5. Which means if I want to travel 100 miles, I expect the range estimate to drop by 112.5 miles. Alternately, if the range estimate shows 100 miles, I would expect to travel only about 89 miles. Another important takeaway was regarding charging. When it hits the fast speeds, it's truly quite impressive. If you're an EV regular, you know that the fastest charging happens between 10 and 80%. So to be most efficient with your time, you typically want to charge up to 80% and then drive away. But what I did find was that the ABRP times for charging were quite optimistic. Actual charging took quite a bit longer. So how about cost? What did it cost to drive this car on this road trip? Well, a lot of it for me was free because I was using a portion of the 1,000 kilowatt hours free that we get in the US when we buy a Kia EV6. Now, it's a little complicated to calculate actual cost because some of the charging was done at home and some at public stations. So instead, I'm going to use the cost estimation published by the EPA. The EPA estimates that it costs $1.03 to drive 25 miles in the EV6. Based on this, for the 464 miles we drove, the electricity would cost only $19.12. Compare that to the $86.49 it would have cost me if we had done the trip in our Volvo XC60 plug-in hybrid, the car we would have taken if we didn't have the EV6. That's about 1/4 the cost, which is pretty amazing. That enough should be reason to do your next road trip in an electric car. I hope you enjoyed this analysis and please be sure to check out my other Kia EV6 videos. Please subscribe and consider supporting me on Patreon or buy me a coffee. Please give the video a like, share your comments below, and subscribe to the Driver Download.